I have made many videos about task management already, but I still get a question. Which app to use when? What is the comparison between them, strengths and weakness? So here is the video. This is a comparison video amongst all apps available in Microsoft platform. Now, some of you are in a hurry, I know. Usually the fashion in YouTube community is to keep the best till the last. I will save you the time. The conclusion is, the best app for comprehensive task management in Microsoft context is Microsoft Project. No other apps are serious enough which come anywhere close. The only caveat is it requires additional purchase. If you are serious about task management organization-wide with absolute accountability and fast execution, there is no alternative to Microsoft Project. Now, with that out of the way, let's go into details of how I reached that conclusion. So how are we going to compare? What are we going to compare? These are the apps, right? From simplest OneNote to most complex and comprehensive project. We will compare all these apps against the same parameters, benchmarks, categories, and then we will see which one fares how. So let's start simple. OneNote, basically used for taking notes, yes. But it has a Control 1 shortcut, which is the to-do item. Now that to-do item, many people use as a task list. Don't do that. That to-do item is just for a checklist. If you really want tasks and you want to monitor them, you want to sort them, prioritize them, then tasks must go into Outlook. And while you're in OneNote, yes, you can add tasks to Outlook. Type something, right-click, use that flag icon and choose the deadline. In fact, if you use the custom, you can create a task in Outlook and in the same breath delegate it also to someone else. So that's the correct way of integrating Outlook tasks with OneNote while you're in a meeting. Now, what are the disadvantages of this? You will see in the OneNote column, there are many no's. And why is that so? Because OneNote is not designed to be a task management tool. It has given a facility to create tasks in Outlook. So all those things happen in Outlook. So that's about OneNote. Now let's talk about Outlook itself. Unfortunately, Outlook is going through a transformation and Microsoft has created what is we call it as a new Outlook, which at this point of time, everyone hates, literally, because it's a dumbed down version. Maybe it'll evolve and become better over future. But at this point of time, I have genuinely tried to use it many times, but I have again come back. The problem is Outlook task folder is a very good option for creating a task list for myself and delegating work. Delegation is an important part of life. So the current way in which Outlook task folder works is perfect for my work and delegated work. How do you put the work there? Just put your task and deadline. How do you delegate work from there? That's the tricky part. This works on Windows version of Outlook. You have to open a new task, put the task and deadline, and click on the assign task button and put the email ID of the person. Now that has a workflow. Other person gets the task, marks it as complete. You will be notified. Even if that person doesn't work on the task, even if that person deletes the task, your task folder will show that delegated task. And that's accountability. Even if other person forgets, you can manage. So it's a really good way of managing your work and delegated work. In fact, Outlook task delegation, the way it is today, is really powerful. I have a detailed video on it. Have a look at it. Unfortunately, now everything of this task is dying in the new version because it's getting completely replaced by the To-Do app. To-Do app is good because it works on browser and all that, but it does not have all these features. If you look at the comparison, it's obvious that except for a few things, everything is available in Outlook tasks. Now, don't use it for shared task list. That's not the job of Outlook. That's why there are other apps. Now, let's talk about the To-Do app. It's an important app. If you have not installed it on mobile, please do it immediately. Log in, it'll sync with Outlook. On day one, To-Do app can be very confusing because it has so many sections. But before we go there, let's understand what does it sync with. In Outlook, we saw tasks. I can have my tasks, delegated tasks, and tasks delegated to me by someone else. All these will sync with the tasks section of To-Do. That gives you some clarity. Now, there may be a base task list, or you may want to create a separate project-specific task list. So in To-Do, you can create a separate task list, give it a name, add people to it, and now within that task list, you can delegate work to each other. That's very good. Only one problem. It's a shared task list. So unfortunately, you give a task to someone, that person can delete it, and there is no audit trail. So if you trust each other with this caveat, use it. But it's not foolproof. You need to know about it. Next important section of To-Do app is the Assign to Me section. That consolidates shared tasks from different places. What are those places? Loop components. Loop components come from where? Can be Teams chat, it can be email, it can be Word, it can be a loop page by itself, or it can be meetings, action items in meetings. All of them assigned to you will come there. Very good. Automatic consolidation. Another place, you have created a team in Teams and we have channels for a project. In the project, we have a project plan, which is in Planner. So in that project, what has been assigned to you, those will also consolidate in Assigned to Me. So that's how To-Do app is an aggregator of tasks from all over the place. It allows you to create tasks in itself, and it also gives you other originating tasks on a platter. It is a good app, but it has some disadvantages. And when you are going to use it as a main task list, you need multiple views. You need the flexibility of grouping, filtering, sorting. All those are missing. And of course, no accountability for delegation. With that in mind, use To-Do to your advantage. I already have a detailed video on best practices of how to use To-Do. I'm sure you will like it. Now let's talk about Planner. Now many people create plans, create a group, add people, and use Planner in a standalone manner. That's not a good idea. Why? Because yes, it does allow you to create a shared task list. But whenever a group of people are going to execute work in a team, are they just going to manage task lists? No. They are going to discuss. They are going to have files. They are going to have meetings. All kinds of things. Where is all that going to happen? Planner is not going to help you. You are going to send thousands of mails to each other. So to prevent that from happening, it makes absolute sense when you have a long-term activity like a project, first create a team in Teams, create relevant channels for different modules of the project, phases, whatever, and then in one of the channels, add the shared task list. And that shared task list is Planner. I have a detailed video on how to use and not use Planner. Have a look at that. Now, Planner has multiple views, filtering, sorting. So for all practical purposes, it looks very nice. It's only one big disadvantage. That is, anybody can delete anything. So if you trust people in the team and you have some accountability, then use it. But remember this disadvantage. Now, before we go ahead, let me give you a task. Subscribe to the channel. Like it, subscribe it. Click the bell icon. You know the story. Now let's talk about the Loop app. It's designed to manage task lists which are ad hoc, short-term coordination. It's not a replacement to Planner or To-Do. So where can you put Loop tasks? Well, I would say most important use case is you are doing a meeting and there are action items. Put Loop task lists. Easy, effective, gets tracked along with the meeting. Even if it's a recurring meeting, that task list will carry forward. Perfect. Another common scenario, I've put few people in a group chat and I want to coordinate execution. Again, put a task list there. In fact, you can put Loop task list in Word as well as email. Very good. Ad hoc, short, small task list. Now, what is the benefit on the other side? You are delegating the work. Very good. The person on the other side also needs to know what work has been delegated to me. So imagine I attend 20 meetings. Across 20 meetings, I may have been given some tasks. I don't want to go to 20 meetings manually. That's where To-Do app comes in. Remember, it's an aggregator of tasks. So in the Assign to Me section of To-Do, you will see all Loop tasks which have been given to you. So best of both worlds. But there is one lacuna. Assign by me is missing. So what do you do? So either you create a Loop page, put tasks there and then copy paste them into Teams, or whenever you create a shared task list in Loop, copy that link and put it in a Loop workspace page. Either way, you build a set of tasks which you have given to others, and that will give you a comprehensive list of assigned by me. I know this should have been there out of the box, but for various technical reasons, you have to build it like a workaround, but it's a good workaround. Consolidate multiple Loop task lists in a single Loop workspace page. Now, when to use Loop, when to use Planner? Obvious question. So remember, Planner is best for long-term coordination, shared task list for a project or a project plan. Where does it go typically? In a channel. As of now, loop tasks are not available at all in channel, but even if they do come, Planner is a better option, and loop for short-term coordination and execution. I have a detailed video on how to use loop in meetings. Have a look at that as well. Now, all these task management tools don't have two common needs. One is, I need a Gantt chart because I am doing a project management and I want it to see visually. And second, I want linked tasks. That means if I have a long task list, if task 3 gets delayed, task 4 should automatically get delayed because unless 3 happens, 4 cannot start. So those kind of relationships cannot be created using any of the tools we have discussed so far. If you want that kind of stuff, you have two options. One option which is out of the box inside Microsoft 365 and one proper project management tool which is MS Project. So let's look at the SharePoint part of it. Many people have asked me, can I create a list in SharePoint and put standard columns for a task and create a task list? No, you don't need to do that. There is already a task list app inside SharePoint. Unfortunately, when you go to SharePoint and click on add an app, you don't see it. You have to go to classic SharePoint, then say add an app, and then you will see a task list. In fact, it's quite a powerful task list. It allows you to have assigned to, which is a proper authenticated person. It allows you predecessors and successors. It allows you subtasks. And most importantly, if you change the view, it even gives you a Gantt chart view. Of course, it's not a proper project management tool. It will not do resource allocation. It will not do load balancing. It will not reduce the duration if you ask more people to do the same job. So those kind of things is still proper project management tool, but better than all the other things we have seen so far. So if you have never explored SharePoint task list, have a look at it. I have not yet made a video on SharePoint task list, but if you think this is an interesting idea, I'll be happy to create a video. Let me know in comments. And finally, if you look at the comparison table, everything which you ever want is there in only one tool. That's called Microsoft Project. I'm sure some of you already use it, but most people who are managing tasks do not use Microsoft Project, and there is also the need of purchasing Microsoft Project. It's not a part of Office 365. But having said that, it's a real professional comprehensive project management tool. Now, many people who already have MS Project don't use it for all kinds of task management. Now, that's a lost opportunity because all the things you would ever want in task management are there. People create project as a project plan for a formal project. That's good. But even if it's a standard task list which you want to share, think of using project. That's another use case that increases the number of use cases where Microsoft Project can be used. If you use it that way, the cost is absolutely justified. Why? Because you have already seen all the other tools. Yes, they are good in their own right. There are some strengths, but a lot of weaknesses. And then you are doing jugglery, workarounds, extra effort to fill those gaps. Project doesn't have those gaps. It works out of the box. That's why think of using it as an enterprise-wide task management tool. I am going to create a video very soon about Project as well. Now, I'm sure some people are thinking, why should I not use Jira or XYZ or ABC? There are lots of third-party tools which do the similar kind of stuff. The reason behind that is Jira was primarily designed for DevOps, so it's very good at it. Yes, you can customize it to be a generic project management tool, but if that is what you want to do, MS Project is way better. There are many other third-party tools which also apparently do project management. They also may be good in their own right. But why MS Project is still better than them? Because of the integration with the rest of the platform. So eventually, the tasks which you delegate in MS Project will appear in Assign to Me in Todo. So that's kind of integration no third-party tool is going to give you. So simple. If you're taking notes and you want action items to be embedded there, OneNote and convert to Outlook. Simple. If you're conducting a meeting and you want to delegate work during the meeting as action items, put loop component. If it is my task list, your task list, own task list, with delegation peer-to-peer, Outlook task list is the best. When Outlook task list dies, you'll have to create shared lists inside Todo and with the disadvantage that people can delete it, that's the only thing you have. Project-specific tasks, you go to Planner. Add that in channel. Loop can also be used in other ad hoc places like group chat, email, Word, and so on. And finally, you want proper task management with links and Gantt chart? The free solution available is SharePoint Task List. And most comprehensive, best way is Microsoft Project. So that is how you do task management. I know it's a long, complex video, but I hope I have been able to give some clarity and use cases which you can actually confidently use based on your discretion and also based on the need, what you're trying to do. I'm sure you will have some questions at the end of it. Please feel free to ask questions. And remember, when you ask a question, it's not only you or her going to benefit from it. I will also learn in the process, and everyone else who is looking at the answer will also learn from it. So asking a question is also a way of learning. Think about it. So that's it for now. Thank you.